I want to tell the story. This is a kind of memorial video of someone we called the Godfather in Scientology. A wonderful British guy from London called Marshall Goldblatt. Why was he called the Godfather? Because Marshall gave tons of money to the church. Marshall almost could not say no. And the word spread. Every salesperson under the sun, moon, and stars. I mean, he would give money. They would call him up for ludicrous things like, we want to give a leather-bound library to Lithuania, or we've got to translate all these into Ukrainian. Can we please put LRH libraries in Pakistan? And believe it or not, Marshall would give the money. He made a lot of money in real estate, but he also was one of the main clients of the Feshbach brothers, right? And he was a multimillionaire. Marshall was what the church called an illegal PC. You walk in the Church of Scientology, if you've been on Valium for 3 weeks, with light two-way comb to a shrink, you can be deemed an illegal PC. They don't want you. You could almost say the Church of Scientology is paranoid about you if you've been linked to psychiatry. Forget about it if you've been for 3 days locked in a mental institution. Now, I said this is a memorial. Marshall died a couple of years ago, and I'm going to tell you the story. Marshall had electric shock. He talked about it quite openly. This is not confidential. He talked about his electric shock. He had electric shock when he was in his early 20s in London. And this made him an illegal PC. What is an illegal PC? Anybody that takes counseling in the church is called PC, pre-clear. You're on your way to the state of clear, so you're a pre-clear PC. Marshall had this electric shock, but he had money, and the church wanted these big bucks. So he would get onto services. He befriended me for that year that I was senior CS of Celebrity Center when it was on La Brea. And some years later, by now I was working at Office of Special Affairs. I was Heber's assistant. And Marshall called me and said, Karen, they won't let me go to Flag. And I said, Marshall, I'll make a couple of phone calls. So I call up the commanding officer. I believe it was Ron Norton at the time. It was before Debbie Cook. And I call them up and I say, Marshall Goldblatt has given hundreds of thousands of dollars. And you could almost hear the pin drop silence while they're calculating. It's a high roller, like Vegas welcomes high rollers. I said, do you know, are you aware of the campus known as PAC Base, the complex in Los Angeles? And the person at Flag said, yeah, we've been there. I said, do you know who got that for the church? He said, no, Marshall Goldblatt. Whoa! See, Marshall, the church is very secretive and disingenuous when it buys property. It knows that in the outside world it's hated. When the Fort Harrison was bought, they came out as United Churches of Florida is buying the Fort Harrison. Well, that lie was quickly fizzled out as a complete lie, because when people looked it up, there was no United Churches of Florida. So again, the church's lies. Why not come out and say Church of Scientology is buying the Fort Harrison? It had to lie. Anyway, Marshall Goldblatt was used as a straw buyer. Thank you, Jeffrey. Straw buyer. So there were three Jewish business partners that owned the property. It used to be Cedars-Sinai Hospital. And these three people owned it. Now, Los Angeles is very much zoned. Everything is zoned for what you're going to use, the function. And because Cedars-Sinai moved out to Beverly Hills, the hospital, Kaiser Hospital all around it expanded and got more and more beds. And now the amount of beds for that area was already gone. As far as the city was concerned, you can't have more hospital beds. Kaiser grabbed the bed quota. So now these three Jewish people were left with a hospital, a lot of little rooms. But no permits for beds would be allowed. So it was a dead balloon. Marshall comes along and he gives a story of his real estate, and he acquires the complex for $3 million cash. $3 million in cash. The whole of Big Blue, the whole of Los Angeles Day, Esho, the bridge building, which is now IAS, AOLA, all the parking lots.
It's an entire city block.
For $3 million.
Less the self-realization
temple. And it was Marshall who got it for the church. So here I am on the phone. That was a long detour. Let's get back to Marshall. I'm on the phone and I'm telling the senior executive at Flag. And do you know that Marshall got the church assigned? Marshall was the real estate agent that acquired. And they said, okay, Karen, we'll be looking into it. Next thing is Marshall got full clearances for Flag. Electric shock be damned. Marshall has money. I can't even tell you how much money he gave them. He was rich for everything, just everything. He was a non-stop person who gave money. And he was dubbed the Godfather because he was like a Santa Claus. He used to live up on Sunset Plaza Drive. And we used to go there on weekends. A lot of CO members would hang out by his pool. Those were in the days where you could hang with someone who was non-CO. Nothing like that is allowed now. So now we come up to 2 years ago. And I get some emails from Marshall. And he says, Karen, what is going on with the church? And I write to him, and Marshall is reading the web. And then Marshall, I try not to get into it too much because he's... But he knows that Mike Rinder has blown. And he thought the world of Mike Rinder. And he said, Karen, for Mike Rinder to blow, something is really wrong. We continue talking back channels. And then Marshall started writing some sad emails. Karen, they won't allow me back on the Flag land base. I've had prostate cancer, but it's been completely in remission. They won't allow me back. So he had returned to me because I got clearances from him. And then Marshall's emails got sadder. He kept writing to Flag, wanting to go back. He could not believe that after those millions of dollars he'd given, that he would be a discard. He couldn't believe it. Then I got the final email. Karen, I haven't written to you for a while because I've been really ill. In fact, I was in a coma for a while. And then one of his secretaries wrote to me a week later. We are writing to everybody in Marshall's address book. We're very sorry to let you know that he passed peacefully, blah, blah, blah. My goodness, for 40 years, Marshall was a Scientologist. They drained him of millions of dollars. And when he was down and out, bleh, I'm kicking my foot, I probably can't see it in the camera. Get out the door, you illegal PC. We don't want you, we don't want you dying on the flag land base. He died greatly upset that the church he had been loyal to for 40 years considered him so deadbeat that they would not even allow him back at the flag land base. Just another story of how the church treats its own.